Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow Industrials right now down 107. You get the NASDAQ off 37. S&Ps are off 12. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Jack Gleason at MajorLeagueTrading.com, as we do each and every Thursday at 40 past the hour. Jack Gleason, what's happening, brother?
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Morning, Jack.
Great, man.
Reviewing some charts. Oil continues to dive lower, although it's up today. But, man, it's really come off since, I guess we talked about it, what was it, last Thursday?
It's been quite a week, man. Right?
Yes.
Last Wednesday, we were at $74. We went down to 66, and then, yeah, quite a bit this morning, but still quite below where we were last week. We got your chart
so
up here.
So we're looking at your chart right now. Talk to us.
Okay, cool. So oil, I'm going to pull it up here as well. I'm looking at kind of if-then statement, whatever trades first.
Yes.
So on the lower end side, the support level I'd look for is a 65.80. That would be a check back to the bottom of the range. We had futures roll over in the oil contract
okay.
a couple weeks ago. So a lot of times when we roll over, we'll retest some of those major levels. So that 68.50 to the downside, I'm interested on a potential long position. And then if we can rally first, I'm looking to actually short into what would be the full 50% retracement from that most recent high. That is that 70.78 level.
Yep.
And see, I've, got that marked off with that red box. So whatever trades first, it could be higher first or lower first, regardless. Both of those levels are of interest to me. And you can see, I always like to say, if I'm looking at a trade, look left of the chart. Is there a consolidation phase there? And you can see both at that halfway back short at that 70.78 level. There was the consolidation before the most recent breakdown, so I would expect naturally there to just be resistance there on top of being a halfway back short. And then on the other side, on the long at the 65.80 level, you look left of that chart, you can see that's a consolidation before the breakout higher. So that's where I'd be anticipating. It's also an extension. I don't have the whole high to high up, but it's from, like, I think it's from last August high to high. It's continuously held those levels. And so those are the two levels I have for oil. So mark those up, set your alerts, and then we can move on to the next one if you guys want, or we can continue to talk about
oil. No, absolutely. And I love what Jack's done here, folks, which is really cool. You take the Fib numbers, he's taking the consolidation, he has some real clarity. Basically that's where you're setting it up. And when you have your back against the wall, well, guess what? Bottom line is that you're selling at one side, you get the stop on the other side. You're buying at one side, you put the stop on the other side.
Totally.
It is. There's some real clarity there.
Nice and clean.
Man.
Yeah.
Keep it math-based.
There's no doubt, man. There's no doubt. So the next one.
Where do you want to jump to? I know we got a couple other charts. Russell,
we'll go with the Russell.
Perfect.
Okay. It's the strongest first all. Start off, Russell's been the stronger market here today, although last week it was the underperformer. So the fact that it's kind of, at least today, leading us out of the consolidation is something I want to pay attention to. Now, the Russell got a reversal out of, what was that, on Monday when we kind of peeked down into the close. What that level was just, once again, the full halfway back long from that most recent swing low that you see on that chart there. We just traded that level, and that was enough. Buyers had gotten stopped out as we took out the previous week's lows into Monday, sold it down into that halfway back. Looks like they got trapped because there was an instant reversal. We haven't retested that level. And then the prior day's low to high, so yesterday's low to the overnight high, targets up into 1700.9, and that's on a more recent target. So if that starts trading today, we're trading 1698 now, so it's not very far away. That is where I would expect some profit taking. But on larger time frame targets, if we continue to hold these support levels, that's going to give me a measure up to 1734 where we're currently trading. That's where I would target over the higher time frame. So that's what I'm looking at in Russell. I do like the fact that it's leading here today. I think some of these other markets are going to be more in a consolidation phase. Us holding the prior day's low to high and sticking that 50% is always a good sign that that's going to be one of the stronger markets, because the S&P didn't do that, the NASDAQ didn't do it, the Dow didn't do it. All of those markets traded below Wednesday's low when you got the Russell holding the 50% retracement. So look for the Russell to lead us out of this consolidation at this point in time, and that's what I got for that market.
Nice. And, Jack, it's amazing that the Russell always can get a little tricky because that move so quick into the close, because they put so much into the close, whether they're buying or selling, When you look at the volume characteristic into the close, it's huge, man. I mean, sometimes it does 20% of what it did all day into the close, and it's like they jam it either way, so it's intriguing.
Yeah, all of the ETF rebalancing and, you know, whatever they
exactly.
do. That. Yep. But that's what makes those levels react is when you get, because, you know, those traders that are typically like, I mean, you had the breakdown stops getting hit on Monday, but those, you know, the institutions and stuff, they're not really looking at charts. You're just going, okay, we got to sell this and buy this.
Exactly.
Of whatever. And then that creates an opportunity for traders. And when you see that instant reaction, you know, that's when you really want to start paying attention to, hey, is there a bigger level in play here? And, you know, my opinion, there is.
Totally. And the next chat we have is the pound yen, huh?
Pound yen. What they call it, the dragon, which is, you know, so I trade a little bit of Forex, specifically on Nadex. So anyway, large halfway back, we came in here today. There was really a nice rally over the last few weeks. We got a three-and-a-half-day pullback into that 50% retracement. I almost love to see that, where you have like a nice steady rally for a couple of weeks and then a sharper pullback into that halfway back long. So that's going to target much, much higher. Let me actually give you the full target. But, you know, we are trading 146.79. You know, if you're looking at Nadex, you got the 146.80 strikes. But all the way, that upside target would be 150.59. And the pound yen moves more than any other.
Ooh, that's a big baby.
That is.
That's a big baby.
We
I like
big
that.
Moves.
I
totally.
Like that. Yeah, totally.
Yeah, so pay attention to that one.
That's absolutely huge. And listen, folks, you know, you can come over to our website at TFNN. You go right under Nadex News. Jack is always over there having some great articles, great webinars. You know, that pound, you know, last week we had a lot of action with Brexit, and I guess that's going to continue. And it's really like, okay, what's really moving that?
There's so much up in the air
there
over
is.
There. It's like,
there
yeah,
is.
I mean, it's the constant news cycle that just keeps on giving, you know. You play a technical, I mean, you know, good news is bad news. I think that last week, wasn't there a big draw on oil?
And there was. So 12 million barrels, I think, was last week before.
And it crashed.
Yeah, it jumped up to $74 in the span of 5 minutes,
right.
And then it was down $4
right.
over the next, like, 4 hours. Yeah.
Which is just crazy.
Right?
So,
I know. How does that? Yeah.
Yeah. You got to love it.
They might have read it wrong, you know. Maybe the algo.
Something was in that report, man, that said sell, sell, sell.
Well, we know that, you know, the market is deviant. The market's job is to take the most amount of money away from the most amount of people in the least amount of time.
I like that, totally.
And that oil market last week definitely did.
You got a 12 million barrel draw, and then oil drops $4 this man. And what would have happened if you got 12 million surplus, right?
Oh, my
you
God.
Build. It's like,
seriously.
It's crazy.
Seriously.
Yeah.
And, you know, we just went through the natural gas numbers. I got a little pop out here this morning. So
that's
gonna,
I haven't checked that yet.
Yeah, it's going to be intriguing watching how that thing shakes
and
up.
Yeah, and nothing too surprising on the numbers, right, as in, you know, 10 billion cubic feet off. But, it was up like 5 pennies in the last, like, hour or so.
Yeah. Well, listen, folks, you can check Jack out every trading day right at MajorLeagueTrading.com. You can check him out here every Thursday, 40 past the hour. Jack, thanks so much for the great education. You have a great one, safe one. We look forward to speaking to you next week.
You too, guys. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks,
awesome.
Man.
Thanks, Jack.
Okay, have a great one. Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are going to be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We have the Dow down 108. NASDAQ is off 34. S&Ps are off 11. We're coming right back.